Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Hi, my name is Silver Ainomae. I'm a cellist and artistic director of Englewood Arts. It has been a great joy for me to be performing here on the stage probably 20, 30, maybe more times, concerts. And joining me for this program, this piece that you just heard, is my wife Anne Ainomae on viola and Stirling Trent on violin. They have both been on this stage numerous times from almost probably 8, 9 years ago, and it's been a lot of fun to do this Beethoven trio for you. So Beethoven basically, I guess, was getting started with writing for a string quartet, but before many of the composers, before they actually wrote for string quartets, they wrote some string trios. In some ways, I guess they could be considered more of a challenge in a composition way, because you have to get basically the same chords and the same textures into three players that you would otherwise have a supporting second violinist.
A little more work for us, but...
Yeah, more double stops for the viola part, I guess. That's always what you hear the violists say about the double stops. And right, opus 3, basically. So it's so different from his late works, obviously, but like you said, some of these late works and some of the humor that he has here also comes more across probably in his later works, when he was more kind of like
pierced. I felt like in some places it had that element of, are you kidding? You're actually writing this?
Right.
Because it's so over the top in some ways, but of course it works because he's such a genius.
Yeah, and it felt like Stirling's part at some points sounded like a violin concerto. With all the passages and just very virtuosic, yeah.
Yeah, I guess so many of the first violin parts in this chamber music is comparable to a violin concerto.
Yeah.
And then I guess for the cello, from my point of view, I always feel like you're accompanying, and then suddenly, before you know it, you're playing passages that you wouldn't want to be playing. So in some ways, it's different challenges, because some of the challenges are when you have to just constantly be playing the first line or the melody, but then the tricky part for the accompanying instruments is that suddenly you're like in the highlight, and you have to play these... Yeah, how do you feel about the E flat major as string instruments?
I had to kind of get my E flat scales and arpeggios out and just get my hand used to playing an E flat. It's such a rare, major.
Yeah, I found it also difficult. The intonation presents some challenges because of that. I mean, violinists, we like to play. You know, my old teacher would say, why play in tune when you can play just a little bit sharp? And it doesn't work here.
Yeah,
so.
Not at all.
Yeah. Yeah, it's interesting, because in some of these string trios, I've definitely felt like, okay, well, why don't you just add one instrument? Make it a little bit easier, you know, give the first violinist a break occasionally and let the second violin play some of these runs as well. But now, after recording this, I feel very good about having
done
this.
Yeah, and as a violist, I want to add that I'm grateful for it to be a trio, so that viola can play something challenging too. All
there
those arpeggios and fast things that usually second violin would play.
Absolutely.
He gave all of that to viola.
You're wearing many hats.
Yeah, for sure.
But there's always a different feeling, you know, when we come here and there's an audience and we start performing. Mm-hmm. I think, for me, just coming here on this stage, as I've gotten used to that feeling of being on this stage, mm-hmm. and in front of our audience and in front of our very loyal supporters, it's given me this place to come back and try to be more relaxed, or try to be less nervous about performing,
yeah.
and just get, you know, use that as an advantage for my focus to just be able to do that performance. You know, I would take this opportunity to thank everybody that has viewed this video, this concert, and keep your eye out for anything that we'll be posting from Englewood Arts. We'll be doing some videos here, and before we know it, we'll try to get back in the hall and safely perform for a live audience whenever that becomes possible again. So thank you so much for your support. Thank you for watching, and hopefully we'll see you soon.